Hello there, welcome back to Coding Stuff, and in this video we'll see how we can create auto image infinite slider. So now let me show you the demo app that we will be creating. Okay, so I'm not clicking anywhere. You can see the images are automatically sliding in 2 seconds. Again, we can slide it by ourselves as well. So as you can see, to this side, and if I didn't do anything, it will still slide. So yeah, let's start with creating the project. So I have created one empty project here, and first thing that we will do, just open your Google Chrome or any other favorite browser, search for rounded image UI Android, and click on this link, GitHub link. We will copy this implementation and I'll paste it in the build.gradle module app level over here. So click on sync now. Okay, so let's close this. I'll delete this text view. We'll add one view pager here. So view pager 2. We'll provide the width and height as a match parent. We'll give it ID as view pager 2. We'll give it some padding from end and start, so of 80 dp, padding from start of 80 dp, and let's close this. So we can constrain it now, and vertically in parent let's change this to match constraints. Okay, so now in the layout I will create one layout resource file that will contain the image, so we can name it as image container, and instead of constraint layout we'll directly use the rounded image view coming from the library. We'll give it ID as image view, adjust to bounds, we'll make it true. We'll provide some radius to it, so corner radius, and let's keep it 8 dp. So yeah, it's done. Now I'll close this, and inside the drawable I have added some images as you can see, so we'll use that images later. First we'll create one model class. We can name it as image. Inside this we'll just have one variable that will be image. We'll create constructor for this, so public image, we'll pass in the int image, we'll set that image with our class variable image, and then we'll create one getter for it, so public int get image, and in here return the image. So yeah, that's it for the model class. Now we'll create the adapter. We'll name it as image adapter. This will extend to recycler view dot adapter. We'll create the inner class, so public class image view holder. This will extend to recycler view dot view holder. Press alt enter to create the constructor, and then inside this we'll pass the image view holder. Press alt enter to implement the methods. Now we'll create our two variables here, so private, first will be the list that we'll pass later. For main activity, this will be type of image, we can name it as image list, and we'll create one view pager 2. We'll be requiring this later, so we'll name it as a view pager 2. We'll create constructor for this class, so image adapter, we'll pass in the list of image, name it as image list, and then we'll pass the view pager 2. This dot image list. So inside the image view holder, we'll inflate the layout. So view equals to layout inflator from parent dot get context dot inflate r dot layout dot the image container parent. And false, return new image view holder. and we'll pass in the view inside this. Then inside the get item count, our image list dot size, and in the inner class we'll find the ID of our rounded image view. Image view equals to item view dot find view by ID r dot id dot it is image view, and then semicolon. So inside the on bind view holder, holder dot image view dot set image resource, this one. So here image list dot get, will pass in the position dot get image, and yeah, that's it. Now we'll move to the main activity. At the first private view pager 2, view pager 2 private, will create one list of image. This will be image list, and again we'll create a reference for our adapter. So image adapter, then we'll find their IDs. So view pager 2 r dot id dot view pager 2, then we'll initialize our image list equals to new array list. Then we'll add some data to this image list. So image list dot add new image, we'll pass in the data here. So travel dot, let's pass the Lisa. So I have added the data to our image list. Now what we'll do, we'll call our adapter. So adapter equals to new image adapter, and we'll pass in the image list comma our view pager 2, and then we will attach this adapter to our view pager 2. So dot set adapter, we'll pass in this adapter, and we'll try to run the app. We'll see how does it look. So yeah, it is sliding, by the way, but we need to add some modifications like animations and all that. So we'll do that with composite page transformer. But before that, we need to add some properties to our view pager 2. So view pager 2 dot set of screen page limit, we'll pass in the 3 here. Then view pager 2 dot set clip to children, will pass in the false here. And then view pager 2 dot set clip to padding, this one, and again will pass in the false here. Then view pager 2 dot get child at, will pass in the index as 0. Then dot set over scroll mode recycler view dot over scroll never, and yeah. Now we'll create the composite page transformer. Okay, let me show you how it will look before we add the composite page transformer to it. So yeah, you can see, and now we will add the composite page transformer to it. So let's just create it. So composite page transformer, we'll name it as a transformer and new composite page transformer semicolon. Then transformer dot add transformer, we'll pass new margin page transformer, and we'll pass in the margin of 40 pixel. Then transformer dot add transformer, new view pager 2 dot page transformer. So we need to implement this method. So we'll create one float variable, and we'll make it 1 minus math dot abs, we'll pass in the position here. So math dot abs gives us the absolute value. Then we get the page here. So page dot set scale y, and here we'll pass 0.85 in float plus r into 0.15 f. So whatever the value of this, it will set that page scaling in the y direction. And then after this, what we can do, we'll call our view pager 2 dot set page transformer, and we'll pass in this transformer. So yeah, again we'll try to run the app and we'll see how it looks now. So we got the 40 pixel margin in between the images, so it looks cool now. But what we want the automatic sliding, so we'll do that now. So for that, first of all, at the top we'll create one handler. So private handler, we'll name it as a slider handler. This will be equals to new handler, we'll initialize it. And then at the bottom, after the onCreate method, we'll create one runnable. So private runnable, let's name it as a slider runnable. This will be equals to new runnable, and we need to implement this method. Let's just put semicolon here. So inside this runnable, what we'll do, we'll call our viewPager2, and then set current item, and we'll pass in the viewPager2 dot get current item plus one. So the image after the current image. So yeah. So then inside the onCreate method, viewPager2 dot will register the onPage change callback. So new viewPager2 onPage change callback. We need to implement onPageSelect method. So in here, slider handler dot remove callbacks. We just need to remove the callback that was previously attached to it. So we'll pass slider runnable, this one. And again, slider handler dot post delay. We need to specify the duration. So slider runnable, and the duration will be 2 seconds, so 2000 milliseconds. Okay, yeah, that's it. And then again, we can implement the on pause and on resume method. So if the user goes out of the app, so he can still be able to use this feature. So first we'll implement the on pause method. So inside the on pause, slider handler dot remove callbacks, slider runnable. And now we'll implement the on resume method. So if user come back, so then what will happen, slider handler dot post delayed, slider runnable, and 2000 milliseconds, and then semicolon. So yeah, so again now we'll try to run the app and we'll see it's auto sliding or not. So yeah, it's auto sliding and it is working. Let's see what happens when the list size is finished, means there are no items in the list. So yeah, you can see it just stopped. So what we can do, we can add this list again to the existing list. So for that, we need to add some code in our adapter class. So inside the adapter, at the top, just after this view holder, we will create another runnable. So private runnable, we'll name it as a runnable. This will be equals to new runnable, and we need to implement this method. First we'll add the semicolon. So inside this, image list dot add all, and here we need to pass the image list itself. Then we can notify the adapters that data set changed. Then inside the on bind view holder, we just need to add one line of code. We need to check if the position is equals to the image list dot size minus 2. So whenever the position of the current item is like a image list size minus 2, means at the third index from the last, so what we'll do at that time, we will call our viewPager2 and we'll write dot post, and we'll pass in this the runnable, so that this will add the list to the existing list and it will be infinite. So let's try to run the app and we'll see it's working or not. We can manually also slide it. So, and this one, the last image, Ryan Gosling, but you can see the Lisa image as well, and then Connor, Selena. So it's working, and now I'll stop the app. So yeah, that's it for this video. Do subscribe for more, and thank you for watching.